there, so I will show you the cover. Because I want to talk about, if you see, there's a mom and a child on the cover. And when they first sent me the mock-up of the paperback, they sent me a picture of a mother snuggling her baby. And I immediately wrote back and said, this is not appropriate because, first of all, he never let me snuggle him, right? My son was on the spectrum. He arched away from me. He didn't want to get close to me. He didn't want to hug me. But also, one of the major themes of my book is learning to respect the otherness of my child and to learn to love the distance between me and my child. I use a quote from the German poet Rilke about how if you learn to love the distance between you and another person, you're able to see that person whole against the sky. Right? You're able to see that person as they really are, without projection, without fantasy. And one of the things that I do a lot when I talk to parents is about getting over that sense of that your expectations are not met, that you have a child who's other than what you thought, that's not like you, that's very different, and how that can be a source of strength and blessing rather than a disappointment. It's the glass half full way of looking at it. And I'm going to talk today about my son Benjamin. This little guy on the book is now 17 years old. He's 6'2". He's applying to college in the fall, and he went to the CIP program last summer. So I'm going to talk about how we got him to CIP, and then what CIP did for him. Because I think that one thing that we haven't addressed, I know for myself that when the counselor at the school first suggested that we consider an AWAY program for him, some kind of sleepaway, independent, skill-building program, I was terrified. And so I'm sure that a lot of you are hearing this, well, this is great, but how am I going to get to the point of actually being able to relinquish my child to a foreign environment, put him in this environment? And one of the things that was always true of Ben and Stephen is Stephen is one of Benjamin's heroes. They haven't met, but he has read a lot of Stephen's stuff, and Benjamin is a musician. Also, he's a classical guitarist. So when he was around 2 or 3, and I was first alerted by a school that we were applying to that they had concerns about him, he had no original language, but he recited poetry. I was an intro. So he was hearing a lot of poetry. He recited entire Sesame Street skits, doing both Bert and Ernie, back and forth. And he sang constantly. And he would memorize like the whole Sweet Baby James album and sing the whole thing from start to finish, with every note perfect, every word perfect, the score, the sound of music, West Side Story, etc. We thought we had this precocious little genius child. My ex-husband is also an English professor. And he was a little precocious genius. But when all of a sudden websites are telling me this is echolalia, this is non-functional, this is rote, this has no meaning to him, he's basically a parrot, he was diagnosed with hyperlexia, which is, according to fMRI scans, the complete opposite of dyslexia, where you're reading very early, but you don't understand conversational language. So he had a lot of trouble with social skills. And I was made to feel that all of these things, these behaviors of going around tapping on furniture to elicit sounds, or singing continually, or wanting to read endlessly and recite poetry, that I needed to get him away from those things because they were symptoms. They were ominous symptoms of a disorder. And I refused to do that. I built on those things. I saw those as his passions, his interests, his strengths. And so always throughout the course of his life, we used his facility with reading, with counting, with numbers. He's torn between being an accountant and being a musician, too. We always use these skills in school, in his nursery school, which is mainstream nursery school on the campus of Vassar. They originally told us we can't accommodate him. He's too strange, he's not interacting, he doesn't want to be with the other children, he's wandering off, he's humming. So I worked with the school, and we suggested that they have him read to the other kids during the reading time. That he hand out name tags because he could read when they were going on field trips. That he'd be the number counter in bingo because he was good with numbers. And this drew the admiration of the other children. It allowed him ways of interacting with the other children. He then went to the Aaron School in New York. Thank you to Daniel Kaufman, whose father founded this incredible school. You're here. And he's still there, and it's been a remarkable experience for him. And when he was in 10th grade, we first met, I think it was you, Travis, or we met, might have been Matt, at a presentation at Aaron. And we were sure he's ready for this. He really is. It was terrifying. I mean, putting him, driving him up there, leaving him for 2.5 weeks, absolutely terrifying. But before he actually went, he applied for a scholarship that CIP offers, and it's a video scholarship competition. And he wrote his own song to the Jackson 5's ABC, he made it CIP, and he played it on the guitar, and he filmed himself doing this. Now, this is a perfect example of how if I had stamped out those early interests, if I had taken those experts' dire warnings that if I allowed him to tap and sing and recite, he would end up never being able to integrate, right? He used those skills, he wrote his own lyrics, and in the process of writing the lyrics, thinking about what CIP would mean to him, right? He talks about, I wish we could show it. I'll put it on my Facebook page tonight so you guys can see it on my author page. All about how independence was going to be developed and all of these skills. And so in the process of writing the song and submitting it for the competition, I was going to sing with him. He had never sung before alone in any context where anybody else was going to watch it. And he said to me, Mom, I'm sounding pretty good. I think I can do this on my own. And he filmed him doing it completely on his own. And so the very process of applying helped him to gain independence. And again, building on those early strengths, talents, abilities, believing in them. He won an honorable mention, I believe. His friend Dave actually won. But he won honorable mention. He went to CIP. About 3 days in, I get an email from one of the counselors, and she has a video. And he's riding on a van coming back from some wonderful outing that they took with them. And the entire group of kids singing Benjamin C.O.P. song. Killed me. Then at the closing ceremony, Benj actually didn't bring his guitar because he said, I don't want to bring my guitar because then I would be isolated off of my guitar. I want to be socializing. I want my social time. But someone had a guitar. They loaned him their guitar. And so he played it on the guitar and all the kids stood around him. And that was their concluding moment. And then they all hugged. And there's a video of this. After doing the CIP program, within a couple of weeks, Benjamin participated in his first mainstream camp. It was a music camp. He did it beautifully. And I remember on the last day, somebody said to me, I said, oh, you know he's on the spectrum. He said, really? I would never have guessed that. And I said, oh, absolutely, yes, yes. And he said, well, if that's some Asperger's, give me a taste of that. This counselor said, he began taking the subway in New York City by himself. Now, there's no direct correlation. They didn't train them to take the subway at CIP. But something about that experience gave him confidence, gave him a sense that he could do this. And he now travels all around the city by himself, completely independently. He performed in our church for Christmas by himself on guitar, which I think is directly attributable to that experience of making the video. He ran for office for the first time in school. His campaign slogan was, you can count on me. He was running for treasurer, and he won. And now he says he wants to run for president next year. We are in the process of recording a CD. Part of the proceeds of the CD will go to CIP as a thank you. A CD of Christmas music. I wrote a piece for Real Simple Magazine about what my autistic son has taught me about Christmas. And I think that there's so many myths about people with autism that need to be exploded, that autistic people lack empathy, that autistic people lack aesthetic sensitivity, that autistic people are not spiritual. I mean, this could not be more wrong. And one of the reasons he said, Mom, I'm ready to share our music to help other kids. So we're recording, I sing with him, just for harmony, just for flavor, not because he needs me. And when Real Simple came to the apartment to take a picture of me, they said, you know, we would love Benjamin to be in the picture. He had never participated, and I'd never shown any pictures of him in the media when my book came out. He said, Mom, I need to show my face, because I need to show people that I am here, and I have autism. I will always have autism. I do not need to be cured of autism. And I want other kids to look at me and say, I can do it too. And so he did appear in the magazine. We are recording this now. I think that CIP, along with the Internet School, when I saw Daniel and when I met Michael today, I said, you two have changed my son's life and saved my son's life, honestly. And last thing, we're applying to not only programs, colleges with support programs, but he got a perfect score on his ACT, which goes away. At the same time, we need support, but we will be applying to some schools about programs and using an outside organization called New Frontiers in Learning to help support him if he can go to that school. And my new mission as a former college professor, Yale is not ready for a kid like Bench. We need to make every school in this country recognize that we cannot exclude people because of their sensory issues. We cannot exclude people because they won't make eye contact if they don't perform in conventional ways. So at each stage of Benjamin's life, I changed my focus in terms of what I'm advocating for. I just wrote a letter to Yale about their policy that you must dorm. They make no exceptions. That is discrimination. That is my new cause. And I can't say enough good things about CIP. Feel free to email me if you want more information. Thank you.